Today we visit Paris, Bruges, Amsterdam, and Iceland in a video that I forgot to post almost 2 years ago. My day starts off in Nairobi at Giraffe Manor for breakfast, connects in Dubai, then finally to Paris to meet Lindsay.
Very warm welcome. We're here in Paris. We've come up this this office building through the sketchy stadium-style stairwell, and we're up here drinking some champagne and watching the sunset. We got up here a little bit early, so we're gonna wait till the sun goes down entirely and kind of ambient blue hour where the city lights are all on and the Eiffel Tower is hopefully all lit up. And still a little bit of sunlight, so the sky will still be blue or orange or pink or whatever it decides to do. But very cool find up here.
Today I'm using the kit lens that I got with my Nikon D500, which is the 16-80, and I love it as a travel lens, especially if you have the time to GorillaPod your camera up here on an observation deck like this. I find that the GorillaPod is incredibly useful for when you don't know which situation you're going to get yourself into. Here I'm using a prism, which is a technique that I stole from Sam Hurd. He's an amazing photographer and a great dude. The problem with my prism specifically here is that it's too small. You have to get a longer one to make it a little bit more effective, but I was traveling and I didn't really know that yet. So it had pretty decent results in Paris, but earlier this year in Chicago I got this shot, so I got really addicted to using the prism kind of for travel photography. I spend a lot of time figuring out my hotel room views before we book a hotel, and I recommend that you do the same, or an Airbnb, because with an Airbnb you can get the exact view that they're showing on the website. I wake up really early every time that I'm on vacation so that I can get the landmarks without any people in them. We also stage a few shots if the hotel is hooking us up with anything for their Instagram or for their social media. And I shoot it in square so that they don't crop it weird on me.
I'm posting on Facebook asking people where we should stay. I said Taylor and I went to Paris with only a hotel booked for the first two nights and the rest of our 6 days here up in the air. And then I'm just going to ask people, where should we go? So it's kind of like crowdsourcing our vacation. I'm hoping for something really odd, like, I don't know what.
Luxembourg.
But I want something weird. I don't want Luxembourg, but...
What is wrong with Luxembourg?
Probably nothing, but... It's not on my list. We'll wait. We'll see if it's on somebody else's.
So someone's writing a comment.
Rebecca used to live in Kitchener. We used to work together. Now she lives in Australia. She traveled all over Europe last year. She says we should go to Nice or Monaco. She doesn't remember the price of the train, but she says we should also check out the catacombs in Paris. So that sounds good. Yeah, so I found this. We used to use it as a decoration in our house. So I decided to clean it up and put some film in it. So I have no idea if it'll work or not, but it's gonna be fun if it does.
When I bought it from eBay, it said A++ working condition, so...
Oh!
I can only assume it's still functional.
A really wise man once told me, Taylor Jackson, that wherever the people are taking all the photos is the exact opposite place of where you should be. So that's where everyone is taking photos. So I have to find something different. Oh, actually, it tells me to go at F16, which is really funny. I'm not doing that. I think that this is what I should always do, just bring a film camera and use this while we're on vacation and just print them out and put them in an album rather than having 1,000 photos on my phone that never see the light of day. It's like an endangered experience.
That's a plug.
So far, it looks like Switzerland. Actually, Andrea Mack just keeps voting on her own, so she's kind of skewing the results in favor of Switzerland. And Kira said to go to Interlaken, which is, I believe, Lake District in Switzerland, which would be pretty cool. I will go on Instagram right now, and I will see what it actually looks like, and if it's fall colors there, then maybe that ends up being the selection. It's usually how I location scout. I just go on Instagram and then type in the hashtag for wherever we want to go. And then you'll see pictures from today. So it looks pretty good. It looks pretty fall-like. So I think Interlaken, Switzerland is number one so far. But we shall see how the rest of the day goes. Thanks for the suggestion, Kira.
Switzerland sounds great. I like the sounds of Switzerland. I really want to go to Amsterdam, but nobody's voted on it. And by the time that they see this, it'll be too late for me to have tried to convince people to vote on it.
Check out this goldfish.
Oh, perfect.
It's terrifying. What is what? It's a box man.
Is it for... I can't tell if it's for climbing or for sex.
It's certainly not for climbing. Lindsay has run out of film on her Canon AE-1 and has resorted to the iPhone.
Such garbage. Oh, Alex Kinsella says Disneyland. That was my vote. I want to go to Disneyland.
I still want Luxembourg.
I don't want to go to Luxembourg. Ooh, this could be good. Matt Barber says go to Epernay and do a tour of Moët and Chandon Avenue de Champagne. That sounds pretty good. I could totally go for an Avenue of Champagne right about now or literally anytime. Well, I bought that big fat Cadillac and I took off down the road. I just might live in the middle and I spied that police boat. And it was coming after me, boy, with their red lights on the glow. So I whipped that wheel around and I cut off down the dirt side road. That big machine wouldn't make a turn and the cops had grabbed hold of me. But the last time I seen my Cadillac, it was wrapped around a tree. Better than where we were. Drop the camera again. I shouldn't be trusted. Thanks, Ran and Jan, for the recommendation. It's a
Here's
view.
A rack focus.
You want me to do that?
No.
Do you want me to poke it?
Nope.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
I'm gonna do it
You're
anyways.
You're really far away.
Here's the secret behind one of my favorite images that I've ever taken of a couple. I was out here at 6:30 in the morning. These guys were taking pictures with their tripod, and I asked if I could do a picture. They said yes. I took this picture. I love it.
The gingerbread capital of the world. Not actual gingerbread. They just have houses that look just like gingerbread. And we checked into this amazing hotel and we asked the girl, how old your hotel? She's like, oh, it's actually not that old, just since 1930. So just as long as pretty much Canada has been around. But it's pretty cool. It's got all this like amazing wood decor. And a Louis Vuitton trunk, for no good reason other than why not, I guess.
What's going on above you here?
I don't know. This guy's just grabbing this kid's trunk. This guy's like giving him a good back rub.
Some slavery.
Some slave children?
Some light slavery.
Slave babies? Oh, I was looking at it in a really cute way. I was like, oh, he's just like grabbing his chunk and stuff, but actually I think it's really aggressive.
This fan is the War of the Worlds noise. So we're going to ask whether we should go to Amsterdam tomorrow or we should go to London because they are both the same price. So we're going to ask and we're going to have people vote and then we're going to go wherever people vote to go. Looks like we're going to Amsterdam so far.
Oh, really? That's what I wanted.
All right, we're out here. We caught the last daylight. The sky is about to turn completely black. I think this is the best time to come out to do cityscapes like this. I have this 16-80 2.8 to f/4 lens on, so I'm going to shoot it at 16. This is a crop sensor, so it's more like 24. To kind of let as much light in as possible, because I didn't really come prepared this evening. But yeah, I'm just going to do 1/20th of a second, 1000 ISO. And it looks like a postcard. Very easy to take pictures when you're in an environment like this. This is probably one of the nicest places I've ever been in the world. It's a medieval town, full of chocolate, gingerbread houses, and pizza. It's a good place.
Facebook friends the option to vote whether we go to London or Amsterdam, and it was an overwhelming response for Amsterdam. Everybody that voted London lives in London, so sorry that we're not going to see you London friends this time, but we will be back eventually. But today we're on our way to Amsterdam. I've never been, so excited. We're staying in a hotel that I guess has converted 20 plus houses kind of along the canal into a very long hotel, so I'm kind of excited to check that out and see what that's all about. And maybe ride some bikes.
My amazing girlfriend found it on the internet because she's the best.
My amazing girlfriend found it on the internet because she's the best.
And she didn't tell me to say that.
And she didn't tell me to say that. Here we have Lisa Simpson's diorama of a beating heart.
Little Tisa, isn't that so sweet? Oh my gosh, this is the chicest place we have ever been to. Look at this little gift. Oh my gosh. I guess they didn't know that I was coming.
What other treasures do we have?
In here. A bike repair kit? You never know, I guess, when you need that. I have smashed two cameras. Well, killed two cameras in the past week. One was a little bit more expensive than the other. One was my like almost daily use camera and the other was not. So here we are replacing the film camera that I brought as the replacement for my daily camera. Just letting the world know that I bought a third camera this week. So we started out with the 600 that broke. The shutter broke on it, and then I didn't want to bring it on this trip, so then I brought a Canon 8E1, and then I dropped it on the floor twice, and then I bought a Ricoh, and the light meter didn't work, which is like sort of fine, except you're paying like double the price at all of these shops, so it's very annoying. So I kind of wanted it to be fine, so I brought it back in, and they didn't actually know anything was going on, so I now have this, so cross your fingers also that we can find a strap that fits in this cute little hole. Otherwise, I'm gonna have another camera smash situation on our hands.
I've attached my camera here using my trusty GorillaPod, taking some pictures down the canal. Kind of nervous about this situation here. Seems sturdy enough though. Let's see what they look like. I think that looks pretty good.
My friend Nina is in Paris. She has a conference to go to in a couple of days, so she made the smart choice to make a little stop off here. We saw that on Instagram and I was like, we have to meet up at the Eiffel Tower and go eat bread and cheese. So we found some bread and some cheese, and that's what we're gonna go do. We're gonna go sit at the Eiffel Tower and be touristy. Side on types of cheese, so I just
so you
like,
bought all the cheese?
Got them all. Here you go, have at her.
But also,
I really wanted to go to the grass, but apparently the grass is no longer. I don't know why, but it's all blocked off over there, and it's all blocked off over here. So,
can you show me if the season is ending? Is this hardship surrender? Throw this curse in the sea. If bravery was the moment you saved me, was the hope of that maybe? You have done it again. If I fail,
first time we've actually seen a clear sky, so I'm hoping we get some northern lights tonight. It is a possibility. If you know my history with Iceland, basically it rains every time I come here, and that has been the case with our trip, unfortunately. But look, stars and clear skies and a moderate option of northern lights is probably a pretty good sign.
What's that noise over there?
That is a geothermal plant. And basically what I'm doing right now is I'm photographing the moss that's like right outside of our room. And during the day it's kind of cool, but at night, whenever cars move and the steam from this geothermal plant kind of wash over, it creates some really surreal landscapes that are definitely really cool. So I'm gonna start here and then I'm gonna go for a walk in the darkness. this looks pretty promising. And if we get something, I might even go for a drive. I don't know if Lindsay will come with me.
I'll consider, as long as Hillary is not being announced as president yet.
It is the night of the U.S. elections, so so Lindsay wants to stay awake to see who wins the presidency.
Who doesn't?
But we are 7 hours behind here, so it's already pretty late, and we have to stay up another 7 hours after 10 p.m. or whenever it actually happens.
Like
to,
The Bachelorette, more exciting.
Yeah, so it's probably easier to just wake up for it again, set an alarm. Look at it, it's totally clear.
Crazy, it's gonna be Northern Lights tonight.
So the good news is the aurora forecast is high, which I haven't seen while I've been here. The bad news is that the cloud chart here, so this is 7 p.m., which is right about now, and we're kind of in this little area right about here, specifically right there where my mouse is. And as we scroll forward, we get a little bit of... we kind of miss all of the beautiful clear skies, unfortunately. But we will see if that stays true in real life.
Can you show me if the season is ending? Is this hardship surrender? Throw this curse in the sea. Like the start of a new year, like fountains spraying their water, like a mother, father. Oh, to see you, if my eyes were set on you, and I would do my best.